Yeah, because if you come here, you pay more expensive. Surprise!
On the road again.
Alright guys, it's time to leave. We're heading to Phi Phi Island. Here, the tour agency come to pick us up.
Oh, is it running propane?
Yeah, but I don't need it.
Okay.
We're just carry it.
How creative we are, huh? You're gonna carry it like this?
Yeah. What time does the pickup is 8. You'll be here at 8.
Okay. รถเป็นสีอะไรครับมีจุดสังเกตไหม
เป็นรถตู้สีขาวเลย
อ๋อรถตู้สีขาวธรรมดา
มันจะเป็นไอ้รถของอันดามันเว็บ
อันดามันโอเคค่ะ
โอ้ยเดี๋ยวก็จะไปกินอะไรกันครับ
Well, thank you, sir.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Yes! Burger King.
Yes.
So, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Our morning started out at about 7:20 a.m. Well, it started at 5:30, but we got picked up at 7:20 by the boat service that we found down by the beach in Onong. And they take you down from, they pick you up, and they take you down by the beach, and you sit here, and then somebody else comes and picks you up and brings you to the port. So we actually ended up extending our stay. We were originally going to stay one night on Phi Phi from Monday to Tuesday, and we were just going to do the afternoon tour when we get to Phi Phi, like the island hopping tour. But with a little bit of research, we found a full day tour. Now that leaves at about 8:30, 9 o'clock in the morning, and you're gone all the way until the evening. So we wouldn't have made it back in time for our boats. Now I'm not too sure exactly how much it is for the tour. I'll let you guys know when we get there. But the tour takes you to 8 different islands, and that's a full day tour. So I'm excited to do some snorkeling and see a bunch of different islands. It is very, very westernized down here. Everything is really basically geared towards the tourists. So you have your Thai food places, but you have everything. You have Indian food, you have burgers, you have Italian, you have everything you can imagine down here. But it gets pretty hot down here, so make sure you got your sunscreen on, you'll be good. Don't you lose hope, we'll survive on our own. They won't find us, cause we'll be long gone. They can only eat our dust. Regret nothing, all I ask is you and me. And they drive like crazy here. He's flying down the streets, beeping the horn, flashing his lights at people. It is just crazy. I still managed to catch a little bit of sleep. I can sleep just about anywhere because of the army. So it took about a nice little 3 to 5 minute nap. Got a little rest in there until I thought I was gonna die. So again, like I said, they pick you up down by the water and they drive you about 35 minutes to the port. And
now you gotta. That is from Aonang area.
Yeah, it's from Aonang area. And now you gotta go in and exchange your tickets and get your tickets. And then we're on this about hour and a half boat ride.
Sorry that if you buy the ticket right at a ticket booth here at the pier, you actually pay more expensive. This is way like not what I expected. I thought that if you come to the pier directly and spot a ticket here, it's gonna
be cheaper.
But it's
they probably get a discount when buying and selling tickets for the pier though.
Yeah, but it's 450 baht. We got a ticket for 300 baht in Aonang area. So consider just buy the ticket from like the area that is full of the ticket booth.
Yep, right called? By the beach.
Yeah. Because if you come here, you pay more expensive. Surprise!
All
I think he's ready to go to the island. He's like running. I've never seen an old man move that fast.
And she pointed this way. Guy, he just wait for us and he come to pick us up. So good.
So when you actually leave mainland from KRABI and you go to get your tickets and get your tickets exchanged to come over to Phi Phi Island, they try and tell you that the tickets that they're gonna sell you for a return ticket are gonna be the cheapest you can possibly get them. They're gonna tell you it's 450 baht. That's not true. Make sure you guys, you know, take your time and do your research like always, because when you get to the island, a return ticket's only 350 baht. So it saves you like $3 to $4 just not buying it previous. When you're on the boat ride itself isn't bad. It's a nice smooth ride all the way here. It only takes about an hour, a half hour, 45 minutes to actually get in from mainland KRABI to Phi Phi. But it's a really nice, beautiful ride across the water. It's really smooth.
It's already worth the money you spend.
Yeah.
300 baht.
Yeah, 300 baht to get all the way from KRABI to Phi Phi. It's really not bad. And it's really nice because once the bay opens up to Phi Phi Island, the water goes from this like dark, dark blue to this crystal clear blue with limestone mountains surrounding the whole bay. It's absolutely gorgeous coming in. It's really, really cool. It kind of reminds me of like Gili T and the Gili Islands in Indonesia, because it doesn't seem to have any motorized vehicles on it. Like, everybody's walking. So the people that actually work for the hotels and hostels and everything come pick up all your stuff in these carts here, and they load them up full of suitcases and push you through the little alleyways all the way around. So it's really cool. It's a lot like Gili, just it seems a lot bigger than the Gili Islands. So they have so many shops, restaurants, markets all throughout the little alleyways, ice cream shops. Everywhere you go, there's places to shop, eat, and then each side you can walk within 3 minutes from one side of the island to the other side of the island and be able to go swimming in each ocean. So right now we're currently walking to our hotel. We're gonna check in, post this video for you guys, and then head out to the water. I can only imagine how the nightlife is here too, just like on all the other islands in Asia. There's just so many bars left and right. It kind of seems like when you're in Asia, the islands are kind of like this lawless area where they don't really have many, you know, police patrolling, and you can kind of get away with just about anything here. Not saying that, but that's just the way the persona of the islands are. It's like this lawless area where, you know, people come to party and have a real good time and not really worry about anything like that.
Okay guys, so we got here at Phi Phi Viewpoint Resort. Look at the view though, before we move into like checking out the room. Very white brand color. topical white. It's real. But here, get into the room. You see the bathroom here. Pretty big. And in total we have one large bed. And we order another extra bed. Look at outside. Wow, pretty cool. We have the balcony here. Right by the sea.
So how much is the room?
It's 2,300 baht at the beginning, but that is like way back, right? But Jimmy just upgraded, so we can stay closer to the beach.
So it's about $100.
Yeah, so Jimmy add 1,000 baht more, so it's about 3,200 baht. And this is high season. The point is that this is, we book it during high season. So that's why.
So overall, for about $100, you can get a nice view out your sliding glass door, and you get a decent hotel room. It's nice and clean. You get air conditioning. You get a nice TV, and we're across from the bar, right next to the swimming pool with a beautiful view. So at first we were on the hillside, but we didn't know that when we booked it. So instead of climbing all those stairs a couple times a day, you know, for an extra 1,000 baht, we ended up coming down here right next to the ocean. So it's definitely worth it.